I really like visual representation. Imagine that you have an AI tool that can develop illustration for you based on the content that you have provided to it. And this tool that I came across will be very helpful for you. So as you can see here, I've been able to create very interesting and beautiful visual representation based on the content I provide to the system. In this presentation, I'm going to show you how to use Napkin AI to generate a visual representation based on the content that you provide to the system. It's free to use for now. So, as you can see, it's free. What you can do is that you sign in and then you'll be able to go. And this is how you're going to see. So, when you go to your library, you can see all the content that has been created, all the illustration that has been created for you. You have all of them when you click on library. If you want to create a new one, you can click on new napkin. So you have two options. First, you can allow the AI system to draft the content for you, and then after that, you can generate the illustration. Or you can bring your own content, then the system will be able to create the illustration for you. So let's start with the first one. So click here. Let's say you are very interested in a topic, right? And you want to generate a visual representation. So let's say I just want to know the types of mixed metal design. So you type the information that you want the system to help you with, and you click on continue. And within a few seconds, you get the information about the topic. So here you can see that the system has provided me all the information that I need to know about mixed metal, the definition of mixed metal design, and then the types, and then give me the different types and also the key features. So imagine that you want to really generate a visual representation based on this information. You can just click on this icon. Let's say you want to generate it for only this paragraph. You just click on this icon. The system, within a few seconds, to be able to generate visual representation for you. The good thing is that you have options. You can choose from all these, the ones that are very interesting to you that represent the content that you want to communicate. So I can see that, let's see. I like this one. So if you like you to click on it, when you click on it, it gives you more options based on the design that you have chosen. You can change the colors if you want to. You have an option to edit, right? You can just click on that and edit if you want to edit. You click on any of the information, then you'll be able to edit. So you can also change the colors if you want to. You can click on the area or that you want to change. You go to the colors, you have different types, and you choose the one that you feel like you want that. So you have an option to change the colors. You can also change the shape, right? So you see how you kind of system, you can really make an adjustment based on how you want it. So one of the what you can do is that you can have to select all of them in case you want to download it. So you select everything and click on download icon here. You have option, you can download it as PDF, you can download it as PNG or SVG. So I want it as PNG. And then if you want a dark mode or light mode, you can choose that. If you don't want any background there, you can turn it off. If you want to maintain a background, you turn it on. And in terms of resolution, you can choose any option that you want. And then after that, you can click on download. So when you click on download, you'll be able to open. And let me show you what I got. So you see how nice this information is, right? You can use it as part of your presentation, right? So these are the options that you have. You can play with it and see there are a lot of options, but the easier way is you just click on the content, this icon to generate the visual representation. Let's say you change your mind, you don't like what the system has generated for you. You can generate a new one, click on it. The system will generate a new one for you. You can choose from the options, right? And then If you're okay, you click on it, and then this is what you have. And as I said, you can easily export it by selecting everything and clicking on the export icon. And another thing is that in case, let's say you want to select all of the information, you don't want to only generate visual representation for a paragraph, you just select the information that you want the system to generate. Just look at the types of the features. I selected the types of the features of mixed method. And then after selecting, you can click on this icon for it to generate visual representation for you or illustration. And then you have options. They're still creating options for you. So the good thing is that you have so much option. And even when you choose from one, you can also choose in terms of the color, how you want a color to look like. And then you can come here and also change the colors if you want to change the colors. So now I've shown you the first option of letting the system generate the content for you, and then you can also generate the illustrations. What about you already have the content? So let's assume that you have analyzed your qualitative data. So let's go to ChatGPT. So I have a data that I want the system ChatGPT to analyze for me so that I can use the content to go to Napkin AI to generate visual representation based on the findings, right? So imagine you have five participant interview transcript, and then you have this research question. So this is about youth who are looking for a job, right? And one of the research questions is, how do young adults navigate mental health challenges during prolonged job searches? So imagine you have this research question, and you want to use ChatGPT to analyze your data so that you can get the themes, and then you can use the themes to generate visual representation. So let's go through the process. So I'm in ChatGPT. What I have to do is I'm going to bring all the five transcripts here and make sure that you have chosen GPT 4.0 if you have the paid version. If you don't have the paid version, you can still use ChatGPT to analyze your qualitative data. So I bring all my five transcripts here. And then what I have to do is to bring information about the purpose of the study, the research question, and also what you want the system to do for you. So I can say that, can you generate themes for me based on the following research question? And then I put my research question here. And I also want to tell the system what my study is all about. Concerning my study, here is the paper of the study, and then I copy and paste the paper of the study here just to have the system to know what my study is all about. And after that, you press on enter and then see what the system going to provide to you. So you see how the system has gone through the data. These are the themes addressing the research question, right? So when you finish, we're going to send these themes to Napkin AI. And then, so let's go to Napkin AI. So you click on Napkin, and this time you click on blank napkin. So now you paste the findings here, right? The theme that you have generated, right? And then you can give it a title. You can say the themes from my study, right? And then what you have to do is that you can copy all of the themes, right? And then click on this icon so the system will generate visual representation based on these themes. So you see how wonderful you can get rich information. So you see the first option. I think this one is interesting. Let's try the other ones. I think this one is more informative. And let me see. Let me go. I really like this one. It gives all the themes and also provide a brief information about the theme, right? So when you like what you want, let's see the next one. This one is also good, but let me choose this one. I like this one. They have options for you in terms of the color and the design of the illustration that you have selected. So now This is what you're gonna get, right? As I said, you can easily change anything here, right? So here I can change the research study theme to maybe something like mental health challenges, right? You can change the font. You can make the words bigger, like extra large. You can change the color if you want to, right? So you have a lot of options here. So when you are done and you want to export, you select everything. So let's select everything here. And then you click on the download icon. You choose how you want it to be, whether it's in PDF or PNG. And then you click on download. And let's open and see what you have gotten. So nicely design illustration, and you can use it for your presentation. So you see how this tool is going to be helpful. Without this tool, you would have spent a lot of hours trying to design a visual representation, helping you to communicate your findings. And you see how this tool is making your presentation of the findings so easy. I hope that this is really helpful for you. If you have any question, you can put it in the comment section and I'll be happy to address them for you. I'm also going to put the link of this tool in the description area so that you can get access to it. Thank you for your time.